I wanted to do a video of just some stuff that's on my reading list and just books that I think a lot of people might find interesting, hopefully. No real theme with any of this. It's just kind of a literary which would be a really weird fetish. I'm gonna have to write that down. Yeah, baby, turn that page. No. I don't really have a set theme, really. But anyway, yeah. We're just gonna kind of get started. I think I have everything. Yeah, I do. This is just gonna go all over the place. I mean, literary, just bleh. It's just fun to do, just bleh. But, let's just get started. We're gonna start over on this side. First thing, this is something I wanted to read for a while, and I didn't really like the movie. I thought the movie wasn't all that great, so I want to read the book and see if it's better, hopefully. 90% of the time, the book's better than the movie. I love The Shining. I haven't read the book. I know, shocker. But this is a cool one. It's by a guy named Max Brooks. You all know this one. Do I need to say more? Yeah. That's been on my list. And look over here. A lady named Susan Jacoby, or Jacoby, or Jacoby, Susan, did a kind of a cool book, and she did a bunch of them, because that's kind of what authors do. You see, authors write more than one book sometimes. Who knew? She did one called Age of American Unreason. I haven't read that one, but I want to read this one first. This one's called Free Thinkers: A History of American Secularism. And I've read part of it before, but I haven't read the whole thing. So, and it's kind of a smaller, paperbacky, So this is kind of a cool idea. I want to read that. So that's why I got it. I picked this one up too. I'm actually a member of this message board. If you know Joe Rogan, and who doesn't, I don't know, people. Once in a while, I'll go to a thread that's on the message board, like, what book are you reading right now, type of thing. And somebody had this book, and I said, you know what? We'll give it a shot. So that's what I did. It's by a guy named Gregory David Roberts. I don't know anything about him or the book. It's just simply called Shantaram. Ooh, it's so shiny. My precious. But yeah, I don't know anything about this at all. I have no idea. But they said it was a pretty good book, so that's why I got it. And yeah. This one, I'm actually. Where's the one I had before? Oh, yeah. I have one over here. Well, they're all over the place because I kind of do it like that. This one, by, I love the names, are Lisa Bloom, called Suspicion Nation: The Inside Story of the Trayvon Martin Injustice and Why We Continue to Repeat It. It looked interesting. I wanted to read it. That's why I picked it up. So, you know. And this one, right, Chia. This is, one of mine that I have. It's all mine. It belongs to me. I don't know what that is. But anyway, great author, great guy. Ron Perlman, Easy Street, about a quarter of the way through. And like I said, it's my copy, my book. It's my book. And I don't know what's on here. Oh well. It's just his autobiography and his life, and so I picked that up. Wanted to read that, so I am. Also, just fell. Frick. Get this over there. You go over there. You go there. You stay here. You don't go there. All right. I told you I'm probably the most unorganized person you'll ever meet. I got these as well a while back. This is pretty much going to be mine tomorrow. Maybe. We'll see how far I get. Yeah, buddy. That's the real version. PBS. This is the real original version from the UK. And it's Downton Abbey. I'm on, well, this one. Because I have it. That's the first one, second three. Duh. yeah. So I picked that up. And I have something in my eye. It's your thumb. yeah. I told you I ramble. You should know that by now. Peter Watson. There's a book I have over. Right there, I think. Right there, maybe. There. Called The Modern Mind. I showed it in the previous video. This is one of his newer ones. Let's see when this one came out. He has a great one called Ideas. That's a good one. He has one, War on the Mind. That's a cool one. This one came out early this year. And I'm going to read it. I got about halfway through, and for whatever reason, I put it down. And never went back to it. And I don't know. So I'm just going to read it again. And it's an interesting idea. Interesting book. The Age of Atheists. I don't know if that comes up. How We Have Sought to Live Since the Death of God. He goes into what Nietzsche said. Goes into just some different ideas, different thinkers. And it's just an interesting kind of a historical thing. I don't know what that was. It's just fun to do. I'll do it again. Watch out. But he's kind of a great author. He's one of my favorites, obviously, since I have that book right there. Definitely get some of his other ones as well, because you can't have too many books. Yeah. Also, I picked this one up. I think I have a couple weeks to read it, but there's plenty of copies there, so I'll just take it back, and I'll just, you know, get it again, or, you know, whatever. But I guess it's a movie. I've heard it's a good one, by a guy named John Green, and it's called The Fault in Our Stars. I don't know a lot about it. I never even heard of it until I found out there was a movie. So, of course, if there's a movie, I gotta read the book, because that's what I do, because I'm a big dork. Yeah. Also, got this. I used to watch this show, and I was a huge fan of it. And so I'm gonna watch it again. Yay. And it was on HBO for a couple of seasons, and I think that was it. Rome. Kind of coincides with the podcast I'm starting up again, so definitely keep an eye out on that one. Yeah. But this was a cool show. It's one of my favorites. I loved it when it was on. It's the first season. It's the second season. And Salt's a season two. Don't use too much. It's bad for you. But I got that. I also got... You ready for this? Check this shit out. I'm stoked. I used to watch this show growing up. I know one of my viewers loves this show as well. Boom. That's the first season. And second season, and the third season, and that's the last season right there. Kind of cool. Loved the show growing up. I actually have some of the dolls somewhere that I used to have. I remember going to one of the malls growing up. Actually, there's only one. Yeah. I remember going every weekend, I guess, every once in a while. And picking up one of the dolls when they were out. And I still have them somewhere. I don't know where they are. But anyway. Also, to kind of go with the Downton Abbey DVDs, there's this one. The World of Downton Abbey. Kind of a cool thing. Tells you kind of the history of the society. Kind of the show. Just kind of cool stuff, you know, just what life was like in that time. And Yeah, so there's that one. We also have this one. This one is the Chronicles of Downton Abbey. This one is obviously the UK masterpiece, Blood Edition. Kind of goes into the people. It goes into the people, and it's kind of what they're all about, and that whole thing, kind of their story throughout the TV show. So yeah, like Thomas Barrow, valet to the Earl of Grantham. That's him right there, and then a section on him. Kind of a cool thing. I'm probably gonna get obsessed with this TV show, so yeah, get ready for a lot of Downton Abbey tweets. Almost forgot this one. J.M. Roberts, this monstrosity of a book. Damn! But it's kind of cool, and it's came out in Sweet Baby Jesus, 1995. It's a big one. That's what she said. But yeah, pretty much history of the world, starting from the very, very beginning and going till, well, 90s with Margaret Thatcher and all of her shenanigans. But yeah, this actually was, I don't want to say, it was a 10, little 10 book series, about that big. I don't want to get all 10, but I just might if I go get through all this one. But there's that, History of the World by J.M. Roberts. That's a cool one. Also, I have, I don't know, sometimes I delve into some more political stuff. This one's by a guy named Tim Weiner. Weiner. Legacy of Ashes, the history of the CIA. I have one right there about Body of Secrets. That one's about the NSA and the history of that. So that's kind of a cool one. This one's by a guy named Robert Draper, wrote a book called Dead Certain. This one's about going inside the House of Representatives. Kind of an interesting idea. This one's called Do Not Ask What Good We Do. Don't worry, I won't, because I know you don't do any at all. Oh, shit. But yeah, that's that one. It's an interesting idea, really. This one's by George Friedman. He is a founder of a group called Stratfor, and this came out in 2004. This one is simply called America's Secret War: Inside the Hidden Worldwide Struggle Between America and Its Enemies. It sounded interesting, so I'm definitely going to check that one out. This one's by Hussein Haqqani, called Magnificent Delusions: Pakistan, the United States, and an Epic History of Misunderstanding. It looked interesting because I read that, and so I wanted to check that one out. I don't know if I showed these two, and if I did, I apologize. David Wilcock is an interesting writer, and what's funny is when I picked this book up, my bookmark was still in it from when I had it before. This is called The Source Field Investigations. I think he was on Joe Rogan's podcast. I don't know for sure, but it looked really, really cool, and so I got it again. And then this one's kind of a follow-up to that one. Right here, The Synchronicity Key, kind of a follow-up to this one. So you have this one, and then that one. And yes, I have had coffee. Starbucks holiday blend. Bitch. finally, I have these two. Actually, this is one I'm reading now by David Rothkopf. Rothkopf. Sounds like a bad disease. What do you have? I have Rothkopf. I think there's an ointment for that. this one's National Insecurity: American Leadership in an Age of Fear. This one's really cool so far. Loving it. Just like McDonald's. I think McDonald's has a. Anyway, this one's kind of cool. I think there's two, as far as I know. Duh, because there's two movies out. Technically three, but that doesn't come out until 16th, I think, or the 12th. I want to say the 12th. Yeah. There you go. The Hobbit Chronicles. This one is, I want to say it's just, it's art, it's design, it's all of just different makeup ideas, character costumes, things like that. Bilbo, not to be confused with the adult idea of dildo. You just wait. Somebody had come up with this ain't Lord of the Rings. Triple X. Costume ideas, artwork. I mean, it's just character ideas. Dwaylin. I think it's just Dwaylin. Ah, Dwaylin. Ah. But that is just ideas, costumes, art, just some interesting things. Kind of, I don't know, it's kind of cool. And of course you have all the different, like I said, costumes, storyboard ideas for the movie. This one right here is kind of the follow-up. It's Chronicles 2. This one is more characters and creatures. Kind of an idea on, let's see, what's this one? The different prosthetics that they used. Just kind of a really cool thing. I mean, to be honest with you. Let's see if I can find a good one. It's just interesting. All the different prosthetics and special effects and stuff to get the costumes and to get the characters to look kind of as close to as they could get. There's a section on trolls, elves. There is Elrond. Not to be confused with Elrond. but yeah, Hugo Weaving is a great actor. I actually remember watching him. The first movie I saw him in years ago was, I think it was Priscilla, Queen of the Desert. We played a drag queen. And then I saw him in The Matrix and then Lord of the Rings. And I mean, he's a great actor, he's one of my favorites. So yeah, that's kind of what I picked up this time around. I do have some stuff I'm waiting on. I don't know how long it's going to take to get here, but yeah. Also, keep an eye open for another video where I'll be talking about that DVD set there, there, and there, which is basically The Matrix, Alien, and The Exorcist, for another favorite things thing. And yeah, so thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I'll see you guys next time. And take care.